سودين الاصليب به وفرقان لنفش وثان عامقة يوسوم رينا نمشي حب اثداخرين مدوثات بشم ابو وبرو روحو حيو قديشو حضلوه شريرو امين شلومو احوبو A greetings of peace and love that I present to you, dear believers, in our Lord Jesus Christ. On this feast of the discovery of the Holy Cross, which falls on September 14 of every year, I wish you a happy and blessed feast, wherever you are in this world, for the cross unites us as one family in Christ Jesus. My beloved in Christ, our Holy Bible contains many verses about the cross. I quote one verse from it today, which is, "The word of the cross is foolishness to those who are perishing, but to us who are saved, it is the power of God." Dear viewers, today we celebrate the power of God with this verse. I offer you an invitation, a reminder, and a supplication to participate in the celebrations of this holiday, which is held in churches around the world. Most churches celebrate with the flames of the feast, prayers, social evenings, and various programs. The important thing is that you and your blessed families attend the activity of this important holiday in our Christian life. Attending this feast gives believers an opportunity to renew their faith and reflect on the meaning of the cross in their lives. This feast is important for the spirituality of the holiday. The special prayers and hymns that are performed in this feast strengthen the relationship between believers and God and bring you closer to God the Creator, who love you and will accept you into His kingdom. This feast is important because it is a community gathering. Attendance is an opportunity to communicate with the church community and strengthen ties between believers. Celebrating together promotes unity and strengthens relationships between individuals in the Christian community. Dear congregations, attending the Feast of the Cross is not only a celebration, but also an opportunity for contemplation and spiritual renewal. The feast can be an appropriate time to review and evaluate your personal spiritual journey. The history of Christianity shared many experiences and miracles with the cross. Out of many personal experiences of people who found the cross a source of inspiration and positive change in their lives is the miracle with Constantine the King. He was the son of Queen Helene, who discovered the cross. The cross appeared to him miraculously, changing his life and the lives of millions of people in his kingdom and after him. Dear youth and Sunday school members of our churches, we thank God for all his blessings upon us. And we thank him for the state in which we live and which we have reached in terms of knowledge, development, social status, and the positions we have obtained. Here, from the position we are in today in America, we remember that human beings are weak. Despite all the discoveries that science has achieved, we need the strength of God and the strength of the cross in our weaknesses to save us from the constant tragedies and the problems in our lives. Just today, Saturday, the 14th of September 2024, I am very pleased to hear the blessed astronaut, Butch Wilmer, who is stranded on the global station orbiting the Earth, when he answered a question by one of the press in America. They asked him about his faith and how he was affected by this ordeal he was going through. The astronaut answered that his feeling about this ordeal is what we read in the second letter of St. Paul to the Corinthians, chapter 12, verses 9 to 10. I opened my Bible and I read the second letter to the Corinthians, chapter 12, verses 9 to 10. It is like this. But he said to me, my grace is sufficient for you, for my power is made perfect in weakness. Therefore, I will boast more gladly about my weaknesses, so that Christ's power may rest on me. That is why, for Christ's sake, I delight in weaknesses, in insults, in hardships, in persecutions, and in difficulties. For when I am weak, then I am strong. That was what the astronaut answered the press, which make me feel so happy. Dear youth of our churches in the world, dear Sunday school students, we also need God in our weaknesses. At the same time, you are the future of our churches in countries that speak English. I want to thank you for sharing and being a big role in our church's celebrations and prayers. Finally, let us pray and ask our Lord by saying, O Lord, protect our people who rely on you. Take care, O Lord, of our children, our Sunday schools, and the youth organization. Strengthen, Lord, the youth in our churches. Help, O Lord, the sick, and have mercy on our dead, because we all rely on you. And we ask this in your holy name, O Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Happy feast to all of you. So dinan lasli bad behwa furqan al nafshothan amga yoso amrinan bshiha ifdakhrain mo.